Julius Malema says, Jacob Zuma failed. He says, no, man, you failed to implement certain things. So why are you back to why are you back in politics? And I thought that conversation was very, in fact, it was worth our, sorry, guys, it was worth our attention. It was worth every single thing, because I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why I think it's worth us deliberating on the matter, and I'll tell you why in a moment. So I was speaking to somebody not long ago, and I said to this person, you see, my problem is, this person said to me, Jacob Zuma and the rest, they failed to implement changes in South Africa. Just like this person is echoing, I think they're echoing the very same sentiment of Julius Malema. This person was, this person was saying to me, local Jacob Zuma, they had failed to get the land without expropriation. And, you know, they go on and on and on and on to name the things that Jacob Zuma failed to do under the ANC. Why is he claiming that he is going to do them outside of the ANC? And I said, wait a minute. Here, let me tell you and let me show you why this time it is different. First of all, I need to show you something about the organizational politics versus a politic where you have power. Oh, guys, I don't know what's going on here. This light is giving me a challenge, and I still need to fix this light. But I'm going to show you that as well, Uguti. There is a difference between between MK Party number one, ANC number two, DA number three, Action SA number four, and then BOSA and ANC. There is just this minor thing, MK Party included. Look at the organizational structure there on and tell me there's something that you need to understand about all of these political parties combined. But before we can do so, go to the ANC. The ANC is an organization that says, we give you the president, you vote for us into power, we tell you who the president is. But even the president himself is not above the organization, is not powerful than the organization. They are saying people will come and go in our organization, but we remain the organization. But contrast that with EFF, for instance. EFF, Julius Malema said something very contrary to the ANC. The thing that I'm trying to show you here is the ability to change things, right? And you will see it shortly. But before we can do so, this is what I expect you to do here. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, having said that, I want to mention this because it's very important. I'm going to play you the video, Julius Malema, but what he said is very, very, very important. Julius Malema says the power that belongs to the deputy president will now be transferred to the president office, meaning his office, meaning he's no longer sharing power. Now, I'll show you an example. I will show you why the ANC versus MK Party versus EFF, These are complete different organizations. So if, for instance, Julius Malema was to be in power and he fails to take the land, it will not be, I mean, you can blame him as opposed to the president of the ANC. And I will show you why. I will show you using even Ramaphosa. But before I can do so, while talking about Malema, take a look at what Julius Malema said about Jacob Zuma. Say, look, about Jacob Zuma here.
Black unity is very necessary, but we can't say black people must be united under the old man. What does the old man have to do with the future? The black unity must be led by the youth, such as Mongez, who are part of the solid organization with solid policies. Black unity cannot be led by people who wake up every day and fundraise a new policy, trying to understand what they stand for. Every day they wake up with a new policy because they were not prepared to build a vehicle for black unity. We have a vehicle for black unity, and that vehicle is the EFF.
So if you pay attention to politics and you look at this, right? Pay attention to this. In the ANC, for Ramaphosa to get the GNU, if you followed how it came about, Ramaphosa had to convince the NEC members to side with him in the GNU. Remember, you are convincing people who are in this organization equally. You are not the one who formed the organization. You joined the organization as Ramaphosa, right? They also joined their organization at their own, right? Nobody claims ownership of the organization here. We all came and we joined this organization equally. You just happens to be the president of the party, but you don't own the party. Therefore, we can recall you and chase you away from the party and dismiss you and expel you from the party. But can a person recall and expel Malema if Malema is misbehaving? If Malema was to be the president, definitely sure, definitely not. Can a person called Jacob Zuma, now as he is the founder of MK Party, can you call him and expel him from the party? No. Chances are these two, you can recall them as from the presidential seat, but you cannot expel them from the party. Why? Because they are the founders of the actual party. So it's very difficult. Yes, I know one will say it has happened with Steve Jobs, where he got fired from his own company, Apple, but later on was recalled. It is his company at the end of the day. It's going to be difficult to get to the point where it's very rare where you are the owner and you get fired. Yes, it does happen, but it's very rare. What I'm trying to say is, if you look at that and you're trying to analyze the situation and you analyze the impact of these people, they need to convince these people who joined the organization equally to side with them. You remember Jacob Zuma. Let me remind you when Jacob Zuma spoke about the land, right? He has been vocal about the land. We need the land. The land without expropriation, even when he was in the ANC. Do you remember that there was an article that was even written where it is said that he was offered $2 billion to step down, right? Do you remember that? Why does that become important in this an understanding of what organizational politics does? By organizational, I mean an organization where you are called and it's not your party. It's founded by somebody else, but you are called to come in. You know what I'm saying? You join the party equally like everybody else. It's very difficult to do certain things under such. But here's the interesting part about this. If Malema and Jacob Zuma were to be given or entrusted by the South Africans to govern South Africa and they fail, do you know why? If they can fail to implement policies now, it will be different. They have more power to control people to side with them, as opposed to the person who's the ANC. It takes time for you to convince people to side with you. But here, it is almost inevitable for people to disagree with you to an extent that they can vote against you in the NEC meeting. It's very, in the MK and the EA, look, and if Jacob Zuma wants to implement something in the MK and Malema wants to implement something in the ANC, I mean, sorry, in the EFF, it's very rare, right? Because of how the structure is different from the ANC. So in the ANC, it was difficult. Some of the decisions, even now, some of the decisions are not to be blamed to the president, but to the NEC of the ANC.